God bless you. My name is Ade Ajayi, by the grace of God, the parish pastor of RCCG Thanksgiving House, based in Chelmsford, Essex, United Kingdom. And we are reflecting from the Daily Devotional Guide written by Pastor E.A. Adeboye, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And the topic today is Be Truly Rooted. I pray that you be truly rooted in God in the mighty name of Jesus. The main Bible passage is taken from Hebrews chapter 6, verse 1 to 2. Therefore, living the principles of the doctrine of Christ, let us go on unto perfection, not laying again the foundation of repentance from dead works, and of faith toward God, of the doctrine of baptisms, and of laying on of hands, and of resurrection of the dead, and of eternal judgment. A memory verse, Colossians chapter 6, 2, verse 7. Colossians chapter 2, verse 7. Rooted and built up in Him, and established in the faith, as we have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving. Before you start to talk to the devil and challenge him about your standing in Christ, it is very important that you examine yourself very well to be sure that you can be firmly located in Him. You need to be sure of your own salvation. There are so many people today who are not really sure of their salvation. They made it into leadership in the church, their choir members, ushers, ministers, and even in some extreme cases, pastors. These are people who go out into activities, and for new churches who are desperately in need of workers, such people will join the church workforce without being sure of their salvation. Coming out later to give their lives to Jesus will become a very difficult thing. This type of people will lack the necessary foundation, and it will be difficult for them to be established and grounded in the things of God, and particularly in the knowledge of the Word of God. When you want to be sure of your salvation, the acid test is to find out the change that has occurred in your own life as a result of giving your life to Jesus Christ. One of my senior friends used to say, "What has Jesus taken away from you, and what has Jesus added to your life by accepting Him into your life?" Salvation becomes the doorway to the things of God. From that point, it is absolutely necessary to start to work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. That process is a very continuum, and place of the Holy Spirit is essential, is absolutely vital in becoming grounded and rooted in the things of God. This is where our Christian experience and conviction comes into play. My brothers and sisters, when you are rooted in Christ, you can assert, as Paul did in Romans chapter 8, that nothing can separate you from the love of Christ. It will become your love and the owner of your destiny. I want to ask you a question, my brothers and sisters. Is Christ the owner of your destiny? Can you say categorically that Christ has become your rock and your salvation? These are the people that Jesus was referring to when He told His disciples to abide in Him, and that when they abide in Him, they'll be able to bear fruits, and their fruits will abide. I prophesy that God Almighty will enable you to be fruitful in the mighty name of Jesus. It is only a well-rooted tree that will have the right root to be able to absorb the necessary nutrients that's required, and also from the good soil to produce good fruits. I also pray that the good Lord will establish you, will establish your family, and will make you a shining light to the world in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that Heavenly Father, You will grant us the grace to be deeply rooted, to be grounded in the love of Christ until eternity in the mighty name of Jesus. My brothers and sisters, I implore you, find a quiet time to study the word of God and also to pray and seek his face. And God Almighty will reveal himself to you personally in Jesus' mighty name. Have a good day and remain victorious.